Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for March the 1st of 2021, well, it is titled the Pelican Nebula in red and blue. So what do we see here? Well, this is what is known as the Pelican Nebula, and it is a region of star formation within our galaxy. And the image has been enhanced to bring out two specific colors that are related to star formation, and those are red and blue. Now, how these are related to star formation? Well, let's look at the blue stars first. And the blue is the coloring of the stars. And we see that related to star formation because when stars form, the most massive stars form first. And those are the largest stars, the hottest stars, the most energetic stars, and they produce the hottest radiation. So highest level radiation, which would be ultraviolet, would be about the hottest radiation that a star could produce. So the highest energy. And to us, since we can't see ultraviolet radiation, those stars are going to appear blue in color. And that's what we see here, very blue stars that have just recently formed. And we know that they've recently formed because many of these massive blue stars only live a few million years, and therefore must have formed within the last few million years for us to be able to see them today. Had they formed billions of years ago, they would be long since gone. And we have to remember that on the scale of star formation, when we just talk about a few million years, is not a very long time, considering the age of our galaxy at about 10 billion years. So much shorter time scales we look at star formation, and many of these stars don't live very long. Now we also see the red color of hydrogen gas, and that is gas that is excited by the stars, the ultraviolet radiation from these stars. Normally hydrogen gas is just nice and clear and we would see right through it. However, when excited by ultraviolet radiation, it will glow. And we will see it give off a distinct red color in the visible spectrum. So that'll give us very red color of hydrogen gas, which is material left over from star formation that we can see here. You can also see some of the dark, dusty tendrils where stars are still forming, dark, denser areas that block out the light from behind them. And within these, likely stars are still forming. So the process goes on. Even though some stars have formed, others are still forming. The stars that have formed are clearing out and changing the shape of the nebula. So what we call the Pelican Nebula now, millions of years from now, would not be called the Pelican Nebula because it would look completely different. And those stars are completely shaping the nebula and will eventually, over a long time, get rid of the gas. The gas will eventually be expelled outward, leaving just the young cluster of stars behind. So that was our picture of the day for February the 23rd of 2021. It was titled the Pelican Nebula in red and blue. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be more from Mars. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.